business of Elmina, and then the English, the British, were in Cape Coast also controlling the business in Cape Coast. This agreement was signed just a little bit ahead of us. So when we get there, I will just point it out for you to see. They stood there and then signed a boundary agreement. Elmina, where we are right now, is the only town in Ghana that celebrates two festivals in a year. Every area celebrates one festival, but Elmina celebrates two festivals. This is the bridge that I'm talking of. This one, yes, we are on it right now. That is where they signed the boundary agreement among themselves. Every 1st January, it's known as Elmina Christmas. Elmina Christmas. People from far and near, if you don't have a food to eat, you don't have clothing, no problem. When you get to that time, just go to any house and they will feed you. And that's one of the festivals that they celebrate. And then they have their annual festival that comes off in July called Bakati Festival. Bakati means pacifying the Benyi Lagoon. They have a lagoon that they fish in called Benyi. So the Benyi Lagoon, they have to perform some rites and a whole day ceremony goes on. In the evening, chiefs and especially the chiefs will be sitting in palanquin and then they parade them along the streets of Elmina. Sons and daughters from far and near come to participate in this wonderful pageantry. There you will see various groups. They sit in a dressed canoe and there is a regatta. Regatta is sitting in the boat and they race to get from one end to the other, and there is a trophy for the first team that wins. Very, very nice. I wish you were to be here one day to see this wonderful festival. Now, take a look on your left. Immediate left. The town over here, not far away, just along this place. Now, the town over here is called Diakro. Diakro means one tree. A little bit ahead of us. Now, down there, the green and the brown thing that you see is thatch. It's known as thatch. Thatch is what we used sometimes in roofing, building, or a summer hut. If it's well-roofed, no matter the rain, it doesn't go in. Because it's sulky, so immediately the water drops on it, it drops down. This stretch of land, the people who live there are fishermen and migratory fishing women or fishmongers. They come from the water region, and what they do is that they move from one place to the other. As a result of that, they don't build proper or nice houses. They will be there for a year or two, move from this place, go to another place, another person also will move in here, and they migrate fishing from one place to the other. So when they came, the chief of Cape Coast gave them this place to stay here. The men go on fishing and then the women do the marketing of the fish, and then they also do preservation of the fish. Along the West African coast, women doesn't fish. Women doesn't fish. It is only men who do the fishing. But one thing that I can also tell you is that The women are very good in marketing the fish. If you allow the men to sell the fish, there will be debt. There will be a serious debt, but the women know how to sell the fish and make profits. So when the men come, they give it to their wives, and they know how much gallons you have used in going on your fishing expedition. They know this, they know that, and they will sell and make profits. With the men, there will be trouble. So women don't fish, but they market and preserve, but the men fish. Someone may ask, why is it that women don't fish? There is a legend that has it that there was a time, some years and years ago, women were fishing. And they went on their fishing expedition. Almost back to shore, their canoe was filled with fish. But closer to the shore, they saw a certain type of fish sparkling, we call red fish, red snapper. And women like red snapper. And they, although their boat is full, they casted their nets. So whilst pulling the nets to pick the fish, the boat capsized and all of them died. So it is said that women are colorful, men are colorless. Because they are colorful and they saw the sparkling in the water with the red snapper, they want to catch the red snapper.
Did he make that up, man?
And all of them were gone. So there was it's a taboo. And they placed a ban on it that women should not fish. And women don't fish. They allow the men. With the men, when their boat is full, they will never, they don't care whether you are blue fish, red fish, whatever, sparkling or whatever, they'll just come ashore. So that's one of the legend, the reason why women don't fish. Here in Ghana, you don't need a license to fish. You need to belong to an association, and then that's all. You have your boats. Maybe you yourself, you are a fisherman, and you don't have a boat. I can buy a boat, someone can buy a boat, and give it to you to go and fish. And you come into agreement, how much percentage this one get this one get that, and then that's all. But you belong to an association, then that association, the government gives them a premix fuel, and they use the premix fuel in their urban motor to go and fish. Fishing is done in 6 days in West Africa. 6 days. The seventh day is a day of rest, and that is Tuesday. Tuesday, when you come to Ghana, go to any of the West African countries, you don't fish on Tuesday. And that is the time, you know, from Monday to Sunday, always working, working, you need a rest. You see, our forefathers, great grandparents are very wise. Your body needs a rest. So at all costs, they should tell you something should happen for you to rest your body. So they will tell you that, hey, you know what? That is the time the sea god also have to rest. The sea also have to rest so that the small fish also will grow. But if you fish every day, all of them will get finished. So in Ghana, Tuesdays, we don't fish.